So what's going on, guys? It's Jim, it's speakboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click onto any of my videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, former WBC heavyweight champion and the man who defeated David Haye on March the 4th, Tony Bellew, says that he will be back in November or December, and there's three possible fights for Tony Bellew. This is what he's saying. And to quote Tony Bellew here, he says, "Before the year is out, I'll be back in November or December. It's Haye or Parker. Wilder is still out there, and I put out a tweet to put him straight after that video that I've seen him do. It's between the three of them. It's definitely between the three of them, without a doubt. There's unfinished business with Haye, but in all honesty, I love the thought of becoming heavyweight champion of the world. So my preference will be Parker. As we all know, Joseph Parker is the WBO heavyweight champion of the world. But obviously, you've got Parker, and you don't know what's happening with his mandatory situation, because Hugo Fury could still get his shot as the mandatory challenger, even though he pulled out of the fight in May. But we don't know with that situation yet with Hugo Fury. And obviously Hugo Fury's got this problem as well with the UCAD hearing with his cousin Tyson Fury. Obviously both men failed doping allegations. The story that the two fighters are sticking to, apparently they were hunting wild boars or some shit like that, and when they were eating the wild boar, obviously the wild boar had something inside of it, like steroids or so. I don't know what this fucking mad story is, but this is the story they're telling UCAD, and obviously UCAD are taking long to fucking sort out the situation with Tyson Fury and Hugo Fury. And then you've got Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder is the WBC heavyweight champion, but he's still got a mandatory obligation to Bermain Stiverhn. I don't know why Bermain Stiverhn is the WBC manager. I don't know what he's done to become the WBC manager, because he's had one fight since he fought fucking Deontay Wilder, or since he lost his WBC heavyweight title to Deontay Wilder in 2015. He's had one fight against Derek Rosse, a high-level journeyman, and got dropped in that fight and looked terrible. And yes, he was going to fight Povetkin in Russia, but I think both men failed a drug test. But for some reason, the WBC just installed him as the mandatory challenger. And I don't know why, because we don't want to see that fight again. Deontay Wilder absolutely dominated him the first time around. Yeah, he's the only man who Deontay Wilder hasn't stopped in a fight, but he still dominated him every round, basically. And it's just a pointless fight in my opinion, but I think we're going to have to see it again. So yeah, that's that situation as well. And then you've got David Haye. Is David Haye going to be fit? He's just split up with his trainer Shane McGregor, and he issued a statement the other day saying that he won't be working with Shane McGregor going forward, and that they feel like they're not right for each other in terms of boxer and coach. So who knows what David Haye's going to do? He's out injured, he hasn't got a trainer. So yeah, it's a lot of money for both fighters. Tony Bellew would get a lot of money for this rematch, so would David Haye. So will the lure of pound coins get them to the fight again? But obviously Tony Bellew's got the chance to fight for the heavyweight title, and I know a lot of people are slating him for that. But at the end of the day, if he was in his position, even though, yeah, you won that fight controversially against David Haye, but at the end of the day, it's still a W, and Fastcore Eddie, your promoter, gets you a WBO title shot or a WBC title shot, you're going to take the shot, because Tony Bellew's being realistic. He only knows he's got one or two more fights left in him, so why not have a crack at the heavyweight title? Do I think Tony Bellew will win the heavyweight title? Do I fork? I think Tony Bellew will win the heavyweight title. I just think Joseph Parker's too young, too fresh, too strong, hands are too fast for him. And the same with Deontay Wilder, too big. Like, look at the size of Deontay Wilder's arms and the right hand that Deontay Wilder possesses. I think he'd destroy Tony Bellew. I think Tony Bellew will take him some rounds. I'll give Tony Bellew that, but I think he'd eventually get to Tony Bellew and take him out. So it's not the best idea for Tony Bellew to be fighting for the heavyweight title, but at the end of the day, if he's going to get paid a lot of money to do it, and it's a chance he probably thought he never had in his career, because at the end of the day, Tony Bellew started off at light heavyweight, probably didn't think that he'd ever go up to heavyweight in his career. So why not take the fight for the heavyweight title? You're going to get paid beer money, and you're going to get a chance to fight for the heavyweight title. So, and I know a lot of people are going to give him stick over the David Haye situation as well, because obviously there is unfinished business. But at the end of the day, David Haye said he was going to take Tony Bellew out in two rounds, and I think he came into that fight injured. And when he couldn't take Tony Bellew out in two rounds, because Tony Bellew proved to be more elusive than David Haye fought, I think David Haye totally underestimated Tony Bellew. Don't get me wrong, I think David Haye was winning the fight in terms of the scorecards before the injury, but I think he underestimated Tony Bellew, knowing what David Haye does in there, because at the end of the day, David Haye's style isn't the hardest style to work out at the end of the day, and especially at 36 years old, when he's a little bit slower now, his timing isn't what he once was. And yeah, David Haye basically, all he does is just load up and jump in with a big right hand. That's all David Haye does. He steps in with a big right hand. That's all he wants to do against guys in there. And Tony Bellew was clued up to that in the fight. So yeah, it was unfortunate that the injury happened to David Haye and we didn't really get a sound enough winner. Even though Tony Bellew did win the fight, it still left a bit of a bad taste in everyone's mouth because of the controversy of it. So I don't know what Tony Bellew should do. I think if the David Haye fight's there and it's for a lot of money, I think he should take that. But if David Haye's not ready, then just go after one of the world heavyweight champions. Why not? Even though it's a massive risk, and we all know he probably won't win the fight, but we've said this about Tony Bellew for a while now. We said he wasn't going to beat Alungu and Macabre. We did that. We said he's going to get absolutely killed against David Haye. He beat David Haye. So Tony Bellew just keeps pulling these rabbits out of the hat. So how long will Tony Bellew's luck go on for? I think in a world heavyweight title fight, I think the luck runs out. But it's the guy's career. If he's going to make a lot of money and secure his family for the rest of their lives, then you can't really knock the bloke. So yeah, this is just my opinion on all of this. Who do you think Tony Bellew should face? What do you think the right fight is for Tony Bellew? Do you think David Haye deserves the rematch? Do you think David Haye won't be ready? And do you think he should fight one of the heavyweight champions? Or do you even think he should move back down to cruiserweight and have a big fight with somebody at cruiserweight? To be honest, I think the cruiserweight division is a very difficult division right now, because you've got guys like Marius Priedus who are very hard men, and you've got guys like Usyk who are very hard men, no homo, and Murat Gassiev, guys like that. But they're not really big money fight, they're high risk, low reward. And Tony Bellew at this stage of his career, let's just be realistic, wants the moolah. He just wants the dollar bills. That's what he's out there for at the minute. And if he can pick up a heavyweight title, then good for him. But I don't think it's going to happen. But all I know is he's going to get a check with a lot of zeros on it no matter what. So yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's speakboxing.